Hello my fellow weirders, for today's video we're going to be doing a book review of The Boatman's Daughter by Andy Davidson. But today we will be discussing The Boatman's Daughter, and wow, what a book. This book was literally just released on the 11th of February there. And it's one of those ones of the very complicated kind of, I can't give you one of those vague synopses that are kind of on the back of a book, you know, where it's like, and then that night their lives changed forever and there are no specifics. This is very kind of complicated, so I'm going to have to sort of tell you a little bit about what happens, but don't worry, everything I'm talking about is at the start of the book and there are no spoilers. So we follow Miranda, who is our main protagonist. At the start of the book, she is a young girl, and her father take a witch to a woman who's having a baby. They deliver the baby and the baby doesn't make it. They then travel out into the bayou. It's one of those sort of communities that you see on TV where all the houses are on stilts in the swamps kind of thing, in like the southern parts of America. And the witch takes this little bloodied body into this wild part of the bayou they've never been to before. Her father follows. She hears shots. Father never comes back. She goes to try to help him. Finds the baby and it's not dead. It's actually alive. Goes to pick it up instinctively to save it, gets bitten by a snake, and when she comes to, the witch has got the poison out of her, has saved her life, has got her and the baby, and dad never seen again, didn't know what happened to him. So she grows up with the witch and the little boy, who they keep secret because he isn't an ordinary child. He's very special. He's kind of like part fish almost. It's like he belongs to and came from the swamps. He's got webbed fingers, he's got scaled skin, he is mute, but he can hear, and he's kind of he's very good with nature and with plants and things like that. So they raise him secretly to make sure he's safe, and she kind of adopts him as her brother, and the old lady kind of adopts them both as her sort of children. But obviously we've got this young girl, no father, her mother died when she was little, all alone. So trying to survive in a very poverty-stricken area of America is not easy. And a local preacher, who they repeatedly say in the book is cuckoo, him and the local police officer approach her and offer her a new line of work. She's got a boat and they need things transported up and down the river, drugs. And she becomes a drug runner for them, moving marijuana up and down the river for them. And this goes on for years and years. And we cut forward 10 years later. And one day, instead of asking for a delivery of pot, they want her to deliver an unconscious, clearly drugged little girl. Which is obviously a bit disconcerting for Miranda. And she then has a choice to make. Does she save the girl and risk her little brother and the witch who raised her? And whatever is now kind of happening in the swamp, because it's like this girl being brought here, the boy, her, it's all kind of like destiny and fate coming together. There are strange happenings, strange weather patterns, the swamp is coming alive. So does she risk everything and to save the little girl, or does she just kind of follow orders and give the unconscious girl over to the preacher and kind of try to put it out of her mind, whatever the hell he's going to do with her, because we all know it's not going to be good. This little girl is also incredibly special. She, when you touch her, when she touches you, have contact with her of any kind, she has the sight, is what they call it, the ability to see everything. She can see you, your memories, your worries, your fears, your past, your present, your future, your death, your birth. She sees it all. And that is quite terrifying for people, because when they touch her, they see it too. And understandably, it scares the bejesus out of them, because nobody really wants to have a vision of their death. So Miranda has to make this decision, and inevitably, obviously, she chooses to save the girl, and the book is then all the repercussions of that. This is a very kind of, it's a book filled with mythology, it's a book filled with fantasy, but not in your kind of cheesy, usual way. It's like more in an earthy kind of way. The witch is a Russian woman, and she has brought with her the kind of Russian house spirits, and she talks about the spirit of the swamps called Lyshi, who I believe in real life is a god, but in the book is a goddess. And this is kind of like Mother Nature. And there are spirits, there are things like the Bannock and stuff like that are mentioned. So it's all kind of folklore, mythology, and it is just wonderfully woven in amongst this horror and pain and melancholy. It is beautiful. I read a review that said that it was like Neil Gaiman in the way that it kind of puts forth all of this mysticism and mystery and fantasy, and I would definitely agree that it's like that, but it's a very kind of, it's a much darker Neil Gaiman. This is, after all, a horror book. At its core, it's got lots of different sort of underlying themes. You've got the idea of family being like discussed quite a lot in the book, like what makes a family your family? Is it who gave birth to you, or is it to do with people who create those bonds with you in life, the people who choose to love you and care for you? There's a lot about religion, about the hypocrisy of religion, about the sadness people feel when they believe that they can get all their answers from a religion and that life will somehow suddenly be better, and that that's not necessarily true, that life is kind of what you make it and there's no sort of band-aid, even if that band-aid is a god. There's a lot about poverty. This is a very poor area and that's obvious, and the way that the writing is done, it's very, you feel how poor these people are, how affected their lives are, how tied they are to the swamp. There's a lot about nature, nature versus modern times versus humans. There's all these underlying themes along with this kind of mysticism, the occult, these creatures, fantasy. It is wonderful. I honestly cannot say enough how much I loved it. It was like, it reminded me a little bit of the Winter Night trilogy in terms of all the Russian folklore that was mentioned, but it takes it and transports it to this, like I said, this very Southern American setting with the kind of, you know, those big old houses on the stilts on the swamp and the river boats, the aluminium river boats, and you know, the spit and the tobacco and the jar and all that kind of stuff. It's very Southern in that sense. So I really liked that. I really liked taking those old kind of cultural references and putting it somewhere new. The writing is fantastic. Andy Davidson is an amazing writer. His descriptions of everything is so layered and beautiful and detailed. The way that he describes everything from, particularly texture, the way that he describes the feel of things, the texture of the boy's scales on the skin, the feel of fire, the swamp and how it like sucks at your boot and stuff like that. The way that he describes these things makes it come so alive when you're reading it. It is so real. And at moments when there's genuine peril involved, that can be quite unnerving for the reader, because they are there, they are with that character, they are wanting that character to live, or if they're a bad guy, to die. And yeah, it's quite intense because it's just so beautiful. It's like you know those big, gorgeous oil paintings of storms, the big beautiful oil paintings with lightning and dark clouds, and you can almost hear the thunder rolling when you look at it. That is like what this book is. It's like one of those paintings. It's like one of those storms all brought down into a book, and it's incredible. It is there's some spooky moments, there are some heartbreaking moments, but there are also some really wonderful light moments that shine through, moments where you really do kind of learn to think about what love really is, what family really is. It's quite beautiful and poignant in moments. The characters are incredibly well written. The bad guys are awful and you just hate them. The good guys, you're really, really rooting for them. You care so much about each of the individual characters, and the way that Andy's done it, he focuses mostly on Miranda, and then there's some characters around her that you get to know more of, and then there's some more kind of out in the peripheral as well. But you become incredibly invested in all of them, but you don't feel overwhelmed by the amount of people involved in the storyline. He's really good at keeping that balance, you know. When you're reading it, he just transports you basically to this bayou, this swamp, and you can smell it, you can hear the thunder, you can feel the rain. It just is so real when you're reading it. And that's the only way I can describe it. It was a really, really, really well-written book, and I honestly can't recommend it. It's definitely a big, huge, massive 5 out of 5 for me. If I could give it more, I would. I read it in like a couple of days because I genuinely couldn't put it down. I was desperate to know what happened to Miranda, what happened to the boy and the girl. And I also I wanted to know what was going to happen with the spirits and the goddess in the swamp and what her plan was. It was all, everybody was so, all their fates were so intertwined and tied together, but not in one of those, you know, cheesetastic kind of ways that you see on the TV where, oh, it turns out everybody's father, and it's like a soap opera. This was done in a really, really well done way, like that it was just this big, rich, beautiful tapestry being created where everybody was interwoven and linked, and all of their fates kind of were projecting to the same location, and you were learning this as they did a little bit at a time. And yeah, it was just really, really well written, really well paced. I definitely recommend it if you're a fan of horror, if you're a fan of darker side of fantasy, if you like the Winter Night trilogy but a darker version of that, this is for you. If you're into Russian folklore as well, I would say this would be worth a read for you. But definitely recommend 100%. What have you guys, any of you read it? What did you think? Let me know in the comments down below. I would love to know your thoughts and also book recommendations, because guys, you guys are on fire. Keep recommending books to me and they're awesome. But that's me for now. I will be doing a little wrap up soon that'll include this book and the other books that I read this month. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell button, leave a like, leave a comment, do all that jazz, guys. And I'll see you soon. Bye.